Hi, I'm Becky. Welcome back to Bellini Bits. I'm continuing on my viewer-requested recipes. Today I'm going to be making some acorn squash, which was requested by a friend that I went to school with, Michelle Fahr. So, what I'm going to start doing right now is I've got my acorns. I've got two medium acorn squashes. This is going to make four servings because we're going to cut them in half. So I'm going to go ahead and work on getting them cut in half. I've never done this before, so I'm not sure exactly how easy this is going to be, so bear with me while I try to hack into these. All right. A little harder than I thought it was going to be, so hopefully you'll have a little bit better of a knife than I've got here. Have a nice butcher knife. It was nice and sharpened. Let's try it from the other side and see if we can get through this. Wow. It's the stem part that's really hard to get through. So, at any rate, let me go ahead. I'm going to try to get through that on this side of it. Alright, I think that's the trick. Go ahead and do it like that. See? Got through. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and scoop the centers of those out, get this other one cut, but while I'm waiting on that, I'm going to go ahead and get started on my sausage, because we're going to be filling these acorn squash with a savory Italian sausage blend. So I've got about a pound of Italian sausage I'm just going to go ahead and throw into my pan right now, get that started, and get it starting to cook down here. And then after I finish cutting open my other acorn squash and scooping out the middles, I'm going to be dicing up finely about six large white button mushrooms, a half of a bell pepper, half of an onion, and one garlic clove. So I'm going to get all that taken care of. We'll come back and we'll go ahead and start assembling it. Okay, so the sausage is all done being cooked. What I'm going to do is actually, before I add the rest of the stuff to that, I'm just going to show you what I did with the acorn squash. I got them all hollowed out, and what I did is I lined my cookie sheet with some foil and then went ahead and sprayed it with some olive oil cooking spray. So I've got them upside down like that. Now I'm going to add a little bit of water to the base here, probably about a half inch or so. Put it in the oven at 350 degrees, and we're going to cook it for about 45 minutes or so, just until it starts getting tender before we actually stuff it. So I will go ahead and get that in the oven right now. Let it cook just like that. And again, it's going to take about 45 minutes because we want to make sure that that gets nice and tender. I'm going to turn the heat down on my sausage, get my timer going. All right, so now to this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add about a tablespoon of olive oil. Dump that right in there. And I'm going to add in my six chopped up mushrooms. There. My one garlic clove that I diced, and my half cup of onion, and half of a green bell pepper that I've also diced as well. So we're just going to let this cook and get a little bit tender before we add the rest of the seasoning to this. So that's going to take about 5 minutes, maybe 7 minutes or so, and then we'll go ahead and add the rest to it and finish getting our stuffing put together. Okay, so all of that's nice and tender. Now I'm going to go ahead and turn the heat off, and what we're going to add to this is I have four pieces of bread that I actually dried out and made into breadcrumbs. So I'm just going to dump this in here, because remember, this is a stuffing, so we need to have something that kind of binds it together. I'm also going to just put in probably about a half a teaspoon or so of sea salt. I guess I should pour this out and come out even a little easier. To give it some seasoning. We don't want to not season it because we want it to taste good, so we dump that in. I'm also going to pepper it a little bit. I don't know if you like it peppery or not, but if you do, add more. And then I'm going to add about a teaspoon or so of dried basil to it as well. Now I am, again, using Italian sausage, so that already has some seasoning in it. And if you end up using just ground beef or plain sausage, you'll definitely want to season it up a little with a little bit more garlic, a little more onion, salt, pepper, and all that. Okay, now also to this I'm going to add about a half a cup of spaghetti sauce. I'm just using traditional spaghetti sauce. If you only have tomato sauce, go ahead and use that. I just had some of this on hand. So rather than opening up a whole can just for a half a cup, I'm just going to use up spaghetti sauce. All right, now mix this together. And then what we'll do is after the acorn squash are done with their preliminary steaming in the oven, we'll go ahead and stuff each half with this stuffing, and then we'll top it Now what I did here is I grated about 2.5 to 3 ounces of Parmesan cheese and about 3 ounces of mozzarella cheese, and we're just going to put that in there too because cheese makes everything taste really good. So that's our plan. We still have a little while to go on the acorn squash, so we're just going to set this aside, and when that comes out, we'll go ahead and finish it up. Okay. Our acorn squash has been in the oven for about 45 minutes or so, and you can see most of the water has evaporated up, and they look nice and soft to the touch. That's exactly what we want. We want to be able to stuff them and make them good. So at this point, probably a little hot to handle, but I'm just going to go ahead and tough it out. All right, we're going to flip them over. And now we can go ahead and fill them with our stuffing. Pan's still hot, so I'm going to move this to carry it over here. Move my handle out of the way. All right, so. And you know what? Just because there's a little bit of wetness in there, I'm just going to take a paper towel because I don't want it to be too wet when I put stuff in there. And I'm just going to kind of dab some of that liquid out of there. All right, get our stuffing. And after we stuff these, like I said, I'm going to top it with that cheese mixture that I already grated, which was the Parmesan and the mozzarella. And then we're going to put it back in the oven and let it bake for another 20 minutes or so until it gets a little bit crispy and browned on top and the cheese melts. So we're going to scoop in, and one of these is a lot deeper than the others. That'll be for whoever has the heartier appetite. So we're just going to put some of that mixture in. Don't get it overflowed too much because this is actually a nice good portion of meat if you think about it. Nice balanced meal. It's got vegetables, it's got the meat, it's got bread. And we're adding the cheese, so it's going to have dairy. This is a pretty good balanced meal. Something nice to do with all the squash that's in season right now. And of course, you don't have to do this with just acorn squash. You could probably use other types of squash, butternut squash or whatever. Zucchini is a good one to stuff. And you don't have to make the stuffing exactly like I have it either. So, nice different variety. We'll go ahead and get this done, and then we'll sprinkle with cheese. I don't know about you, but I love cheese, so I'm not going to be too stingy with my cheese on top of this. So, out of everything that I grated, I'm going to try to use it all if I can. Putting a good handful on top of each one, trying to press it down in there as well as I can. And again, as I was mentioning earlier about the stuffing, you can get creative with whatever meat you want to use. If you don't want to use meat, you can use oatmeal. You could probably use a little bit of flaxseed in there. You could probably use rice, quinoa. Pretty much anything. I mean, barley even would probably make a really good stuffing. So just get creative. Make sure you have your binders, like your bread and your grain, and add the seasonings you want, and it'll all work out. Okay, stuffing's in, cheese is on. I went ahead and upped the temperature to 375 degrees. I'm going to put it in the oven. I'm going to start watching it at about 10 minutes because I want it to start getting kind of crispy around the edges and I want the cheese to get all melty. And that'll indicate that it's done because you can see that this acorn flesh is already nice and soft and it's going to be ready to eat when I take it out. So 10 minutes might do it. It might need a little bit longer to get browner. That's why I put the temperature up a little higher. So we'll just go ahead and put it in there. Keep checking on it. And see when it's ready so we can taste this. It smells amazing and I can't wait to dig in. Okay, I was getting impatient. I had it in for 10 minutes and it wasn't browning because it was only at 375 degrees. So I turned the oven on to broil and now I had it in there for about 3 minutes on broil and it's perfect. I cannot wait to dig in and eat this. Look at this. Just nicely browned a little on top. Hear it sizzling. Smells so good. Now, I can't dig into this right now because I've done this in the past. Take a bite because I can't wait and it burns my mouth. So I'm going to let this sit for about 5 minutes and then I'll give it a taste. Okay, I'm going to taste it. It smells too good. I can't wait. So I'm going to do this one because this was the thinnest base that I had. So I'm just going to put that on my plate real quick. I don't think I need any seasoning on this whatsoever because the cheese is going to add a nice salt texture to it or a salt flavor to it. So I'm just going to try to get a little bit of everything. The acorn squash is nice and tender. Oh, it's just perfect. Don't want too big of a bite because I can't talk. So pull some of that off. can see the steam coming out of it. Looks lovely. Oh my goodness. If you ever get a chance to make this, this is so good. The flavors in it just totally remind me of, I don't know, pizza night when I was growing up. The peppers, the mushrooms, the sausage, so delicious. And again, it's a very balanced, pretty healthy meal, so I would definitely suggest making this. It's autumn time, perfect time to break out the squash and get creative with your fillings. I'll post the recipe on my blog, and I really hope you try it.